Welcome to Kari's Conscious Living.
Hello, my favorite friend. If you haven't joined Cat Club yet, please talk to your mom, your dad, your guardians, your grandparents, whoever it is that's in charge, and ask them if you can join the Cat Club. You'll get 3 exclusive Heidi Cherry and Veya stories every month on the 7th of the month. I hope you can join and become part of the family. Namaste, my little friend. Enjoy your story. Are you ready to meditate with Kari? Lie down on your bed and get super comfortable. You're in for a very, very amazing treat. Veya had been having a very bad day. She was feeling under the weather, she had a runny nose, she'd been coughing a little bit, she might have got cold, she wasn't sure, she was just cold and shivery and miserable. She needed some extra love and care and snuggles from her sisters. You know how it feels sometimes when you don't feel very well and all you want is just love and nice warm soup and a blanket and a good movie or a book. That's exactly how she felt. Heidi snuggled in next to her and Cherry said, "Would you like it if I tell you a nice story? Like a meditation story, you know, to help you feel so much better, to help you relax." Veya said, yes, please, Cherry. Heidi said, "Do you need an idea about a story? I have an idea. You could tell us a story about the moon." Cherry said, yeah, that's actually a good idea. I'll tell you a story about the moon. The moon. Right, okay, but first of all, you have to lay down and completely relax, Veya. Let go of your day, Veya. Let go of any stresses that you're feeling. Let go of any kind of emotions that you're having that are not pleasant. Like, for example, if you're feeling very, very, very upset, let it go. If you're feeling very, very, very sad about something, let it go. If you're feeling angry, you know how you can get angry? Well, actually, Veya, you don't get very angry. But you know how I can get angry? Well, I'm telling you now, if you're angry, let it go. Let go of anything that you feel is not a positiveness in your body. What I mean by that is, if you're having any thoughts about anything negative, let it go. If, by any chance, you're having any doubts or any concerns or anything else, just let it go. Right? You get the message. You get the message, Heidi?
Heidi said, "Yes, I get the message."
Good. Veya, did you get the message?
Veya said,
Yes, I'm letting it go.
Good girl, Veya. Let it go. Now, what I want you to do is close your eyes. Because if you close your eyes, then you'll be able to let anything go so much easier. So listen very carefully. Close your eyes. Close your eyes and shut out that world. Shut out that world around you. That world that's making you feel a little bit cold and a little bit sad and a little bit under the weather. Let's imagine that when we close our eyes, it all disappears. Everything around us goes dark. Because it does, doesn't it? It goes dark with your eyes closed. Literally. Right, close them really tight. Step into the darkness, because the darkness is magical. Imagine that the darkness is actually the sky, and you, Veya, you are the moon. You're a big, shining, bright moon in the dark, dark sky. Your little tiny paws and claws are made of moon. Your little tiny ankles and bones and fur is made of moon. Your little tiny belly and your tail and your front paws and your back is made of moon. You are the moon. Your ears are the moon. Your nose is the moon. Your whiskers is the moon. Your cheeks are the moon. Relax them all. They are. Relax them all. You're shining bright like a beacon of light. Oh, it rhymed. It rhymed. I'm so awesome. Yeah, you're shining bright like a beacon of light up there in the dark, dark sky. There's clouds. No, there isn't, because it's dark. You don't see the clouds. It's the stars. That's right. The stars all around you. And those stars shine bright too. In fact, your sisters are stars in the sky. If you look over, miles and miles and miles away, you'll see Heidi, the star, waving your way. And you'll see Cherry, that's me, another star, shining bright, twinkle, twinkle, in the sky. That's me, waving from over there. Hi, Moon. Hi, Veya Moon. Hi. And you'd say, hello, sister. Hello, shining star. And I'd say, hello, Veya, the big bright moon in the sky. And then, because you're so bright, you're magical. You're light. You're made of light. I keep rhyming, and it's so easy because I'm so awesome and I'm so clever. And the rhymes are just pouring out of my mouth. Like I've been taken over by a poet. I've been taken over by a famous poet. Anyway, back to story. You're the moon, and you're so bright, shining up there in the dark, dark night. I'm so good at this. And then you're shining bright and someone thinks you're made of cheese. But your sister stars say, please, she's not made of cheese. I'm so good. Everything I'm saying is rhyming. And so, yeah, so get back to the story. Yeah, she's not made of cheese. She's made of light. And she shines so bright in the sky at night. And then the moon sometimes changes its shape. And sometimes it's not full. Sometimes when it's a new moon, the magical moon is very magical because it can't be seen. It's invisible. Invisible moon, Veya, that's when you go completely invisible and no one knows where you've gone in the sky. Where did the moon go? That's what they say when they look at the sky, questioning. Where did the moon go? And you say, I'm here. You just can't see me. And everyone else in the sky is still twinkling. Me and Heidi, the stars are still shining so bright. And you are in the sky at night, invisible. Like the Invisible Man, which freaks me out. But you know, you could be like that. You could be so invisible, but you're not invisible. And if you could reach up to the moon and touch it, you'd feel it, but you wouldn't see it. You'd know it were there, but you wouldn't see it. You could smell it and feel it, but you wouldn't see it because it's invisible. It's a new moon. And a new moon means new beginnings. And then sometimes you're a half moon. And then sometimes you're a crescent moon, just like those things that you eat. Are they croissants? Yes, just like a croissant. Or is it a croissant? Is it a croissant or is it a croissant? Heidi said, I'm not sure. Jerry said, all right, back to story. Yeah, sometimes you're a crescent croissant moon. You're so special, Veya. You're so special as a moon. You are the bestest, brightest, shining moon the whole world has ever seen. Just relax your body and be a moon. Let your fur be the moon. Let your paws be the moon. Let everything about you be the moon. And then the moon in the sky that shines so bright needed to go to sleep because it was nighty time and sleepy time. And the moon was so tired from shining so bright for everyone to see in the sky, except when it's a new moon and it's invisible and then it doesn't get so tired. But anyway, yeah, so you're so tired, Veya the moon, so, so tired that you need to go to sleep. Sleepity sleep. Oh, sleep. Sleep, my little angel, sleep. Cherry was stroking Veya's head with one of her paws while she was singing to her. Sleep. My little moon, just go to sleep. Close your eyes and let the world go by. And tomorrow you will feel so much better with no runny nose or coughity coughs. You will feel wonderful just listening to my magical voice. Cherry sang for quite some time. Veya did fall to sleep. Luckily, she liked how Cherry sang. Heidi had fell asleep ages ago. Cherry was very talented and was very, very good at telling stories in a calming, meditative voice. She sounded just like an angel. Well, her sisters thought so. She was very relaxing and calming and loving. And it was exactly what Veya needed to make that snotty nose dry up and go away and get rid of all the coughity coughs and the shivers and the shakes. And the next morning, she would wake up being her normal, happy, loving, kind, sweet princess self. Thank goodness for Cherry. Cherry's so awesome. The end.